Hello, everybody. Welcome back to YNAB TV. I'm here with Mark Bosco. And Mark, thanks for taking the time to sit down with us today. Mark has actually been in my shop, but we're at Colleen Clemens. And the first inaugural vintage was 2008. Now they have some other wines, finally. And the wines are just spectacular. And Mark, tell us a little bit about this facility. First of all, we're on the top of this hill overlooking, if you guys can see, it's just beautiful here.
Yeah, we're technically in the Chehalem Mountains, although we're right across the street from Ribbon Ridge. Either way, we're out in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah, we are.
But we're perched up high enough where we get this beautiful panorama of the Chehalem Mountains on the east side. The west side is the Coast Range, so it's a pretty place to be. And our owners bought this property back in 2005.
Okay.
So it's 120 acres.
All right.
We've got 40 of it planted, all the Pinot Noir, and as you'll see through the wines, that's all we're making are Pinot Noir-based wines.
So you have a rosé in the state and...
In the state reserve.
In the state reserve, yeah. This is pretty cool. I bring my guests up here. This is just such a spectacular place. The funny thing about these tables, this is a good story. I went on Yelp, because that's what I like to do, and I said, boy, this place is so beautiful. It'd be nice if the owners can get some tables. And I think about a week later... You said they ordered? We had some tables. See, that's listening to what your customer wants.
Listen to the customer base. It actually was our owners came out probably the week after and realized there was nowhere to sit. And then they thought, we need some tables.
Yeah.
So the timing was perfect.
It was perfect. And these are nice teak tables. This is beautiful.
Come bring a lunch. And
so when was this planted up here?
So the first plantings, it was 22 acres went in 2006. So one of the wines we're going to try is from our first vintage, 2008. So they were technically in their third year, their third leaf. And every year since, we've been adding a little bit of acreage. So now we have 40 acres planted to five different clones of Pinot Noir.
Okay. Talk about the first one, first rosé you guys have made. And who's your winemaker?
Yeah, so our winemaker is a gentleman by the name of Steve Goff. So Steve is by no means a household name quite yet. He worked as the assistant winemaker to Mike Etzel over at Beaufrère Winery from 2001 to, I believe, 2007. And then Joe, our owner, was able to entice him into coming over here, and he acts as our winemaker vineyard manager. So he's made every wine since our first vintage in 08. And what he does for us is, again, strictly Pinot Noir. And this time of year, we wanted to make some rosé. And Steve loves rosé from, more specifically, the south of France, where the color's a little bit more pale.
Okay.
They're not growing Pinot per se, but the wines are not fruity and sweet. They're more fresh and floral.
And you know, the thing with rosé, and this is the rosé kind of time of year, you know, everybody's coming out with a rosé, is, you're right, a bunch of different colors. I mean, this one is like light salmon, if you will. I mean, just really a pale orange. I've seen them almost like to a neon orange.
Yeah.
Depending on the skin contact. All right, so tell us a little bit about the rosé. Summer sipper.
Yeah, and there's all sorts of different ways to make rosé. We are going out of our way to make this wine. We're taking the more expensive approach, if you will. We're buying fruit from a vineyard down the road, so still in the Chehalem Mountains.
Okay.
We bring it in the winery. We destem half of it, and we let that soak and tank. This soaked for about 6 hours, so that's about as long as it took to pick up that beautiful pale peach salmon color. Then we press that off and let it sit and ferment in stainless steel. So it's crisp, no sugar whatsoever.
This is new wine. Even though there's no sugar, it tastes like it's off dry.
It's got a little kind of effervescence almost to it.
It does, and you know, when people drink rosés, most of people look at it think it's gonna be like a white Zinfandel, but this one here, this would be food friendly.
Absolutely.
With some spicy Thai food.
And I'll be actually curious to see how this wine ages too. Such great acidity.
It does have really
probably hold up for a couple years. It's not necessarily what we're looking for. I think you can drink this young and really appreciate it. And this time of year, when the sun decides to come out, which it rarely does,
it's
been
summer.
Fantastic.
How many cases did you guys do this?
We did 135 cases of this. So this is a wine we're just selling in the tasting room, and we're almost all out of.
There you go. Good.
Yeah.
Fantastic. All right, first Pinot. Let's talk about Pinot. That's why we live here in Oregon, right?
Yeah, absolutely. So we currently make two. And they're both estate grown, so we grow the fruit right here on the property. And the main difference for us is less about where it's coming from the vineyard, and more about the style of wine we're trying to make. So our winemaker, Steve, likes to let all the barrels kind of do their thing. He treats everything like it's the best. And then we do blending trials. And the estate, which this is from 2009, is a wine we're trying to make in a style where you can drink it in the short term.
Case production on the 2009?
This is 300 cases.
Okay. You know, guys, last year, the 2008 vintage, when it was released, you guys just made a drop of wine. Good drops,
yeah.
But drops of wine. Because what was your yield per ton back?
0.4 tons per acre, our first vintage. So
kind of sounds like a Burgundy thing.
It does. Yeah, you know, our vines are relatively young, and our winemaker's approach is he thinks you can make great wine off young vines. You just can't make a lot of great wine off young vines. So we didn't make a lot of wine at all.
God, dude, I just love this Pinot. Slim, this is your favorite wine, isn't it? Yeah, you know.
That's why I want to shake his hand some days.
So yeah, thanks a lot. No, it's funny because, you know, having a wine shop and having all these people come by like yourself and first meeting you when you came by and trying your wine, you have that one moment and going, wow, this is really good stuff. And that's a cool thing. And I'm glad you made a little bit more of the 09 as your plants are maturing a little bit.
That's the goal.
2010, it was probably like the 2008. It's just the weather and the birds and all that thing. And then this year, it's like...
Yeah, who knows what will happen.
Did you guys go through flower already?
I think we're... For the most part, everything's just moving.
Guys,
really
this is
slow.
July. This is the end of July.
I know. It doesn't feel like it.
Isn't it crazy?
Wearing the same thing that I wore in November.
it's just been another year. The whole country is just basking in heat. And if you want to escape it, you go to Seattle or Portland. Yeah. Welcome. Welcome, Al.
Right.
Welcome. All right. Let's talk a little bit about this wine then. The case production was 300 cases.
Yep.
I love the nose on this wine. This is not your grandma's Pinot.
This is not.
This is a heavier, just a really robust.
Yeah, again, the yields were really low. This was our second year, so instead of 0.4 tons per acre, we got about 0.75, so about 3/4 of a ton. So we're kind of asking a little bit more of our vineyard each year, and it's, I think, very true to 2009 as well. It's got beautiful fruit, but it's also got a lot of structure to it as well.
What's your favorite thing about the 09s?
You know, 09s are growing on me, I have to say. I was definitely in love with the 08s, so it always takes me a little while to, you know, appreciate the next vintage, but I like how good they taste right now.
Right out of the bottle.
Right out of the bottle.
You know, 09 is one of those vintages to where it is just fantastic. Poured out, done.
Yep.
07s needed some more time. The 08s, even though they're probably the greatest vintage ever in Oregon, they're even gaining a little bit more complexity with little age, but these 09s is like every 09 I've had so far, I haven't had a bad 09.
I think you're right.
You know, they're just that approachable. And the price points on these wines are decent too.
Thank you. 18 okay. for the rosé, 32 on the estate, and then 42 for our estate reserve.
And that's your most expensive wine.
And that's our most expensive wine.
So this is not a by any means a moneymaker yet. You know, I mean, the vines aren't even producing that much fruit. And you should, guys, if you ever come up here or take a tour, you got to come up here. It's just beautiful on the inside. It's got a huge fireplace. It's just stunning up here.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
I just love this. We're going to put a tent.
If I'm like.
Yeah, if I move in, just don't, you know, just feed me some wine now and then, and I'll be like a sales rep for you guys. All right, let's talk about the last wine. This
All right.
is
2008 Reserve. This is the wine you the actually
eight.
Fell in love with. I remember it like it was yesterday, Wayne. I walked through the door.
Yeah.
Bought this wine for you.
I thought,
and you never looked back.
No. It's a cheap romance.
It was. And, you know, 08 was our first year. And what our winemaker, Steve, did was he just tried to make the best wine he could. So we made about 440 cases of this. Again, not a whole lot. We've distributed some of it. This is the only wine, actually, you'll find outside of the tasting room. It's the only one we made enough of where we had a little bit to kind of play around with. But it's tasting.
You know, if you're going to pick a vintage to start making wine, you couldn't have picked a better vintage in 08. I mean,
very lucky.
Best vintage ever so far in Oregon. And I'm not saying that 09 wasn't great and 06 wasn't great and 05 and whatever. It was just one of those vintages where everything lined up. Jupiter and Mars and everything kind of lined up. And this is beautiful. God, the nose on this wine.
Yeah, what I'm finding too is lately this wine has been in a sweet spot. And I don't know if it has something to do with the age of the vines and being on the younger side. But as 08s go, this is about as accessible of an 08 that I've had.
This is delicious wine.
I think it's going to age just fine, but for some reason, it's tasting really nicely right now.
Guys, when you're here, give Mark or Mary a call and come up to this winery. What are your hours?
We are open from 11 to 5, Wednesday through Sunday.
There you go. And it's a great place to bring a little picnic lunch if you want to. They'll treat you like royalty, and the wines are superb. Anyway, guys, thanks a lot for stopping by. And when I come back, we're going to talk to some other winemaker, some other wine guy, and you're going to have a great time doing it. See you later. Here.